Hi, I'm director Sam Hargrave.
And I'm Chris Hemsworth, and today we're breaking down a scene from our new Netflix movie, Shot by Shot. The movie's not called Shot by Shot, we're gonna break it down.
Shot by Shot, yes.
You show me the kids, all right? I tell my people they pay you. Do you understand?
Come here.
Pay. If not, blow his insides out.
Who is that handsome
devil? Who's that devil?
I don't know. This scene was important for many reasons, but mostly it's the first action scene of the movie. Through every action scene, I think it's important to reveal character, and this is the point where Chris here gets to unleash. On the page, this read as a very kind of chaotic scene. We tried to capture the spirit of that, but we also wanted to allow Chris to utilize some of the many martial skills that he had. So this here, attacking the guy and then sending him down the stairs. Oof. There is a reason why stuntmen exist. You know, like that, there's a hood on and you're falling downstairs and you could possibly hurt yourself. This floor, most of the time, was padded. So instead of having to hide elbow pads or, you know, so you don't get to fall, you're trying to protect yourself, you can go all out and you don't have to worry so much about it. I think we shot this scene over the course of 4 days.
And then came back and shot it again. I was like, oh, that's it. Got it in the can, right. And then you came back and said, oh, I want to tweak some stuff. And I was like, oh, I want to tweak you.
Every action scene has to have ebbs and flows with the rhythm, and then it has to end with a, for me, like an exclamation point. And we just didn't quite have it once we shot it the first time. That first piece, what we tried to do is to show the ruthless efficiency that this character possesses with a weapon. And so we start at the top where he has a weapon, and then we slowly start to take away his weapons and make him improvise throughout the set. I remember it was one, you got smacked on the finger pretty good by one of those machetes.
It was a wooden machete.
Yeah, we
thank you.
Don't use the real one.
I wouldn't say improvised, but it was certainly the scene that was organically grown throughout the shooting of those six days, right? Yeah. Like a lot of the stuff you had heavily prepped, but then you would say, that doesn't look right, we'd do this, and we're kind of on the fly.
Then one of my favorite things about these kinds of sequences, especially in working with someone like you, being in the space and seeing like, oh, he's a little taller than the stunt guy, does this move better? Let's change it to a right hand instead of a left. Having someone who is able to improvise makes something like this a very organic creative process. I love these gags. That table was on a dead man, like a cable that was tied off to the floor, so it couldn't go past a certain point. And then he was able to haul off and kick that table. Editorially, you kicked a table that was free, so that one just went out of frame. No one was, you could kick it as hard as you want. I think you broke at least two tables. So then in the reverse shot, we had another stunt guy kicking it, but it would stop before it hit the stunt guy in the face because that would hurt. But the camera angle makes it look like he's taking it right in the teeth.
Yeah.
And then with the sound effect, it makes it very memorable.
Kick through, same thing, he's on a cable, right?
Yep.
And
yeah,
it doesn't actually hit his
head.
That,
he kicks him in this shot, but in this one, you know, you're in the background overlapping the kick. He runs on his own.
He just runs straight around
on his own as fast as he can, jumps into that cable. It looks like he's hitting hard bricks, and then the way he acts after he, you know, it's, oh, my spine! But that's all acting.
Oh, see that.
See, you felt that and you dummy.
It was a dummy, wasn't it? Yeah, which had a bit of weight in it too.
It did. An idea that we'd had and actually kind of stole it from Chad Stahelski and Dave Leitch. They tried some stuff in the John Wicks with dummies.
You could do a similar move with a stunt guy, but
not land on his head.
No, you wouldn't be able to do it as violently. And yeah, right on its head.
Homage to my character's name, Tyler Rake.
This came from a fan of these kind of movies. If Tyler Rake kills somebody with a rake in this movie, it's gonna be the most amazing thing ever. And I was like, That's actually a great idea. Was his last day on set. No, that's not true. That was a fake rake. let's
I would just be like,
Hello everyone, I'm director Sam Hargrave.
And I'm Chris Hemsworth, I play Tyler Rake. Today I'm gonna take everyday objects and I'm gonna show you how Tyler Rake would use them to keep himself safe. It's a towel from Malaysia.
Good morning. Go. Go, Rake. How would you use that? It's in the. And I'm,
well,
I'm attacking you like
if
this.
If you. I would just be like. That, or I'd see, choke you around the here. Or.
So many ways.
Do some of this.
I'll tell you how I win. I just make you eat this. I feed that to you on your toast, unbeknownst to you. You die of dehydration.
That's pretty good. I rub this in your eyes. It's so salty. And you can't see. And then I beat you over the head with this glass.
Yep.
Whoa. Look out. Ah, nunchucks.
Oh, my gosh. Not only would that work to whack you over the head with, but it would sound really cool. I'm gonna punch a hole in the back of it.
Yeah.
And then use this as a shield, and you're gonna nunchucky and try to bite me.
Says Chris Hemsworth in Korean. Sam, take it away. How would you?
Right. Ah, you just did it.
Nice.
Just
won the fight. You know what I'd do? I'd take this little bit of metal, rub it on the concrete like this. Yeah. Get the end sharp so it's like a razor blade.
Yep.
And then just come up behind it.
Sure.
Would love to see this happen. Look at that. Frisbee.
Frisbee, yep, right in the eye.
A little
slap, slap, fish. Slap. Now, if you rip these pieces off,
yep.
I could wrap it around your neck.
Yep,
and choke you with
you
it.
Could, yeah. Oh, look at that.
Teddy.
See, this is not for fighting. This is when I won the fight, I bring you this in hospital as a...
Sorry.
To avoid a fight, give a gift.
Immediately pacified by seeing this. Oh, yeah, this is good. A little wallop on that one, couldn't you? Yeah, you totally could.
After a cue, you wrap you up in that. Bury you, or put that over the top of the hole. Be like, come fight me over here.
And you know what's straight inside through. The bottom is all the little cones.
Spikes.
Yeah, little punji sticks.
Little knives in there, you just fall straight into.
I might just hold it up
then
like this
up
and say, this. Guess what's behind the rug? My fist. Tickle you to death.
Yeah, it's a little bit of slapping. I don't know, it's not much strength to it. Ooh. I think you poke someone in the eye.
You sure could, that is, that's sturdy here.
Yeah.
Not my eye, there you go, okay, great. Mm. Yep, right in the neck.
Yeah.
You can make two. Break it in half. Now you get two sharp ends.
Yeah, two sharp ends.
Yep.
Or just go down your throat, pull out your stomach, rip it out, chuck it over there.
Effective.
Toss it on the barbie and eat it right in front of you. Yeah, wine comes in a plastic bag.
Oh, it's heavy. You know, I could drop that on your toe and then you drop down to my height and I slap you.
Or pour the red wine over myself. Be like, oh, don't hurt me. I'm already dying.
Oh, I thought it was blood.
Tricked you.
Yep.
Bye. Here's a tip. You're out one night. You're drinking this with your mates. A bit tired. No worries. You got yourself a pillow. It's a little mustache comb. How about that?
I think you could. If you get it in the right spot, that is pretty sharp.
In the eye, definitely.
In the eye, that would cause some pain.
Yeah, there you go.
Look at that.
Good.
You share mustache comb. Mm. Oh, look at that.
I didn't know about this one.
You'd
unless it was like
your...
a look over here kind of.
Yeah,
and then mid-fight, just kind of cool yourself down. Lower your heart rate.
Right.
Get back in there.
That's so it helps you recover. Oh, that's how I feel about you. It's a heart.
Little mini Thor hammers. What about lining them up like that, and then I'll just like slam your head on the back.
Right in the eye.
See, we're not fighting, we're just like playing games together, you know?
That's how most fights start.
What we do with this, definitely poke in the eye.
Yep.
Or
club.
Avoid a fight, be like, listen, let's sort this over a baguette.
Break
half
bread.
For you, half for me.
Yep, and off we go.
Oh, no carbs on Wednesday.
Turn right onto the bridge.
How far past the gate?
Front gate. Turn right. Up ahead, make a
Hi there, here's today's daily fact. When you think of Thor, it's hard to think of any face portraying the character other than superstar Chris Hemsworth. But back at the time of casting, Chris nearly lost the role to none less than his own brother Liam, who was getting call after call and was in the creator's top 5 picks. Chris was eventually scheduled for a new audition, in which a sibling rivalry pushed him to do his best and ultimately obtain the world-famous role. Remember to click below to subscribe, on the side, for more great content.